Hi, my name is Ifar, and I'm one of the TAs for the Transport Phenomena course, which you are attending right now. In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve the exercise given in week 4, subsection 1, about the director who has to assess whether he wants to replace the glass windows in his building by plastic ones or not. Since all windows share the same properties, the situation sketch is complete when you draw just a single window. For the rest of the building, all the rest of the windows will work in exactly the same manner. To start off with, we are given some figures like the total window area, which is 300 meters squared, temperature difference between the outside air and the inside air, which is 10 kelvins, the current energy bill, so based on the glass windows, which is 20,000 euros a year, the cost of changing to plastic windows, given in euros per square meter, and heat conductivity, as well as the thickness of both the glass and the plastic windows. The first question in this exercise tasks us to find the heat flux through the glass window. We can calculate the heat flux with Newton's law of cooling. And since the driving force is from outside to inside, we can add to the sketch the heat flow, which will be from outside to inside. The heat transfer coefficient H can be calculated as the Nusselt number times the conductivity divided by the thickness of the window. For conduction through a plate, the Nusselt number equals 1, and the other parameters are given, so the heat flux can be calculated pretty straightforwardly as 2000 joules per square meter second. The next question, 4.1.9, follows along at the exact same lines, but uses the properties of the plastic windows instead of glass. So you'll end up with a heat flux of 1500 joules per square meter second. Question 4.1.10 tasks you with calculating the ratio of heat flows, which will by nature be equal to the ratio of the heat fluxes, since the area through which the fluxes flow are equal. The ratio is 3/4, and we'll call it eta. Just for convenience purposes, we are going to reuse it. The break-even point is reached when the money saved by converting to plastic is equal to the initial investment costs. The investment is the total window area multiplied by the cost per square meter, and it equals 45,000 euros. The amount of money saved each year can be calculated from the ratio of heat flows found earlier as 1 minus eta times the original energy bill, since this represents the original bill minus the new bill. So the amount saved is 5,000 euros a year. The break-even point can then be calculated in a straightforward manner. It's after 9 years. For the last question in this exercise, the thickness of the plastic windows changes from 2 millimeters to 3 millimeters. The calculations, however, stay the same. So the heat flux will become 1000 joules per meter squared second, the ratio eta becomes 1/2, and continuing down this route, we end up with a break-even point after 4.5 years. I hope the approach to this exercise is now clear. Good luck on the next ones.